president of Costa Rica says there are no reports of casualties from a major earthquake there this morning. The 7.6 magnitude quake was centered on the northwestern Pacific coast, about 140 kilometers from the capital, San Jose. The earthquake caused a lot of shaking and some damage. One hotel owner near the epicenter says everything fell off the shelves and that the ground was rolling. Tsunami warnings were issued for much of Central and South America, but are now in effect only for Costa Rica, Panama, and Nicaragua. Jenny Harrison joining us now with the very latest on this from the International Weather Center. How's it looking?
Hey, Fanulia. Yeah, just as you said, of course, the good news that the tsunami warning has been lifted for many areas. Let's just show you, first of all, where we are talking about. Remember, you've got all these major plates. This is the Cocos Plate to the north. We've got the Caribbean Plate. The Cocos Plate actually is the subduction plate, which goes underneath. And this is what has happened here. So there it is. There, of course, the epicenter, as you say, 7.6 magnitude, downgraded from the initial estimate of 7.9, 40 kilometres deep. The nearest place, Nicoya, just 11 kilometres, as you can see, from the epicenter. And in actual fact, 141 kilometres to the west of San Jose. Now, in total, San Jose has got a population of 335,000 people. You can see the shaking was actually strong across this entire region. Overall, about 500,000 people would have felt strong shaking. The structures in this area, they are overall quite vulnerable to earthquakes. But having said that, this particular region is very underpopulated. It's actually a very big tourist spot. There's lots of jungles people visit. There's resorts on the coast. And the pager informations coming out of the USGS are actually green, which means very low likelihood of casualties and certainly of any major damage. So, of course, we'll get more information in on this. But overall, despite the fact it was 7.6 magnitude, Fionnuala, it was 40 kilometres deep. And it seems so far that we haven't had any major reports of any damage or casualties.